two public hearing items tonight. Both of these items, the person that's presenting them will have time to do that. And then if any opposition or affirmation for these two projects will be given a chance to speak. The total time of the presentation and the speaking, you'll be given 15 minutes. So each side will be given 15 minutes. So try to keep that in mind when you're up here speaking and everything. So at this time, Matt, I'll call on you to make the first presentation.
Mr. Thank you, Mayor. This first public hearing item is a plan developer request by Crown Real Estate Development. This is property we recall that some 3 months ago. It is located at 2107 Baytree Road, currently zoned community commercial, and consists of 7.42 acres. It's immediately next to I-75, near the south of the Greater Lowndes Planning Commission, and north across Baytree Road from the redeveloped property. Complex plan wise, community activity center, this is a character area. This is a very intensive commercial type activity center. In this case, we're similar to the Valdosta Mall area around exit 18. This is an older area, which is in your packet on the screen, that shows the land as it looked prior to the apartments and prior to the redevelopment and into the south since about 6 years ago. Currently, the subject property looks like this. It's vacant. That is the Grove Apartments there in the background. This is how it looks from the west. I said five, this is a maintained clear lot. This is the former house lodge property. I said five, the other to the west, a little better view of the Grove Apartments. And then there's also a small apartment complex immediately to the east on Baytree Road. The master plan is in your packet. It's a proposal to develop this as 5 buildings of mixed use. This one is needing a plan development. They're proposing both commercial and multifamily to share the same building. And like we talked about in the work session, if the uses were not in the same building, and was wanting to put these on separate parcels, we would not even be talking about plan development. But the proposal is to build this in phases, total of about 140 dwelling units, 45,000 square feet of commercial space, plenty of parking to satisfy all this, actually, a little extra parking. The larger building on the lower right part of the screen, that is a 5-building parking deck. The inspiration for the project was an existing similar type development that was built out in Tallahassee. It's called College Town. It is near that Michigan City. That's a little better picture of it. As we talked about during the rezoning case 3 months ago, they had told us that they were considering coming back as a plan development to make sure the uses of commercial multifamily. And that's why they are here. Land use pattern, overall, the zoning map really tells the picture. To the north is multifamily, and to the south is commercial. They're going to do both on the same development. And right here with the Planning Commission recommended this at the meeting on February 27th, and recommending approval to you with 9 conditions, and providing a consistent and comprehensive plan and the plan development for these standards. Glad to answer your questions you might have.
Questions from council?
All right, at this time, is there anyone in the audience who would like to speak in favor of this request? Anyone who would like to speak in favor? Come forward, state your name.
My name is Jimmy Jones. I'm the architect on this project. Office is located at 1806 Plum Street. I have here with me the owner, developer, Matt King, and also the civil engineer is here with you, which is Matt Phelps, and we'll be glad to answer any questions that you may have at this time.
Does anyone have any questions of Jim?
I'm just curious, is there going to be a church located on this property?
No, sir.
You're taking the street church.
You caught me off guard.
Any other questions? Thank you. Is anyone else who would like to speak in favor of this request? Anyone who would like to speak in favor? Is anyone in the audience who would like to speak in opposition to this request? Anyone who would like to speak in opposition? We have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion?
That's what the entire condition.
Sure.
As presented with the.
With the conditions, yeah.
Okay, the statement was as presented.
All right. Did you have a question?
I do have a little bit of discussion. And it's not directed to the project, to what the project's going to do to the neighborhood down there. And I've said this before. I think we're overloading that short road with traffic. And I know what the traffic counts say, what the traffic counts are. But there, I have to look at the big picture. The big picture is we have vacant lots down there. Wooded areas that are going to be developed in the future. That's inevitable. And I'm worried about the amount of traffic on this road that we're not going to be prepared for. We tend to wait until we have a problem to fix it, when we need to make sure the problems don't occur by addressing the traffic now. So I'm just challenging the engineer and the manager, everybody, to stay on top of this. Great project, be good, but we can only put more traffic on that room, and then when the rest of that area is built out, we're going to have problems. We tend, and we don't need to wait, we need to fix these problems and prepare for them now. Other than that, good luck.
Any further discussion, comments? Hearing none. Motion is to approve the application, so all in favor say aye.
Aye.